Also new this morning, gunfire in a Rancho Cordova home.
KCRA3's Mike DeSalle has been on the scene all morning as investigators try to sort out the victims and the suspects. And boy, this scene is pretty confusing, Mike.
It's complex, but they're starting to make sense of it. First and foremost, take a look behind me, and that garage door right there is the key starting point for this entire investigation as they are trying to piece together exactly what happened to spark a gun battle here this morning. Take a look. This is the same garage, but around 3 o'clock this morning, you can see what happened here. This is video of actually a person shot in the head who was taken to an ambulance. They believe that this person was a suspect. Now, what they believe started all of this somehow was that a woman was arriving home here where she lived. In the garage, she witnessed something happen that caused her to flee. What they believe happened is the homeowner confronted someone in his garage. A gunfight between those two erupted. The homeowner was shot in the upper chest. The suspect shot in the head. The woman who was here, she fled so quickly, she just rammed through the garage door. They suspect she fled to a nearby pharmacy where she also called police to report this shooting. And then on top of all of that, there was another gunshot victim, or I should say gunshot suspect, who showed up at an area hospital. The bottom line is, as neighbors are waking up and learning of this story, they're calling it bizarre, but not entirely unexpected in this area.
I'm extremely shocked. I mean, I can't believe that this happened right here, but that's what everybody says. You know, it never happens on our street, but it does.
All I can say is I sleep with a 357 next to my bed and two dogs. And it's fortunate that we have dogs to alert us, because unfortunately these days you just don't know what's going to happen.
And back here live again, we believe that we have two victims here. One of the theories is that this may have been a home invasion, or it may have been a robbery targeting the people who lived here. They say at this point it is way too early to say there's any connection to drugs or a gang. So it really is one of those mysteries where, in the word, I know it's cliche, but in the words of a sheriff spokesperson himself, there are more questions than answers at this point in time. But to expound upon the second suspect here, the one who walked into an area hospital, we were told that he went to Mercy San Juan, where investigators had looked at a suspect vehicle there, and inside they found a driver there. So not only do they have a second suspect, they believe, who was here at this scene, but they believe he was driven there by yet another person who has now been detained and is being questioned. So a lot of different scenes going on here. We have the pharmacy this victim went to, the female victim went to. You've got multiple hospitals, and you now have a suspect vehicle. Investigators fanned out all over the Rancho Cordova area in Sacramento County. Live in Rancho Cordova along Old Placerville Road, I'm Mike DeSalle, KCRA 3 reports.